Welcome back, rankers. I'm in India, Chennai. Ta-da! And I shouldn't really be wearing this because it's my wedding outfit for Monday. No, I'm not getting married. Someone from our office, Vandy, is getting married. A lot of you may know Vandy. And yeah, we got invited to the wedding. So here we are in Chennai. It's an amazing place, an amazing city. Seen so much already and can't wait to see a lot more. It's heaven a ball. Anyway, I wanted to talk to you this week about site migration. And the reason is, I know I've banged on a lot about it before, and we did a webinar last year about it, and a lot of you didn't see the webinar. But the reason I want to talk to you about it today is because at the internet conference this year, formerly known as PISA, and this is the conference, the e-commerce conference I go to every year. It's the best e-commerce conference in the country. I've been to all of them, I think. I don't think there's any I haven't been to, but I've been going to this one, I don't know, about 6 years now, 7 years, something like that, that I've been attending, and we've been exhibiting there for about 3 years. And the difference with this conference to other internet or digital conferences, or any conference really, is that there's a real community feel about it, and there's everybody is there to help one another, share ideas, network, exchange learnings and hardships and all those sorts of things. And when you go there, it's like catching up. Well, it is actually. It's catching up with a bunch of old friends. And you know, I'm one of the oldest, I think. But if you can get along, it's on the Gold Coast in Queensland at the end of May. And I'll just give you the actual date here. So it's... Bandwidth's a little bit slow here, so this will be probably a shorter show than normal because I have to upload it. there you go. May 25 to the 27th on the Gold Coast. There's all sorts of early bid specials and all that sort of stuff, so you can go and check out the site and find out that for yourself. But if you can get there. Phil Lay, the organizer of the conference, just does an amazing job of networking and finding some awesome speakers, and this year's no exception either. I mean, you've got some pretty awesome talent coming from overseas. We've got Tim Ash talking about conversion. We've got Gary Wheelhouse from Harvey Norman talking about stuff. We've got Gabby Leibowitz. We've got Paul Greenberg from National Online Retailers Association. We've got Grant Arnott from Power Retail, Click Frenzy. So if you are in e-commerce, and I tell this to all my clients, that you have to go to this conference, even if it's just to network, because what you will learn from mixing with the people there, you're not going to learn anywhere else. It's invaluable. And the reason I wanted to talk to you about it today is because I'm doing a spot on site migration up there this year. And I mean, look at this lineup. Tony Nash, Booktopia, they're doing amazing things. But I'll be doing one on site migration. We did the webinar last year on site migration. A lot of you saw it, a lot of you didn't. But I just want to go over it again because we've been talking about it in the office recently, and our national sales manager came up to me with another site the other day and he said, why do web developers do this? Why do web developers push new sites live and not have all the SEO in place for the migration? And in our experience, and of course there are exceptions to this rule, but the people that we see are the people that have problems, right? So that's the only ones we're seeing. And 9 times out of 10, the web developer has just ignored all the SEO elements on the existing site and pretty much blown them away. And so the rankings drop overnight. And I'll take you through a couple of slides, which gives you, I guess, the overview of what you need to do. And if you are coming to the conference, of course, we'll go into all this in more depth. And the bigger the site, the harder the migration. The more complex the site, the harder the migration. So, you know, you might be going from, say, a WordPress WooCommerce installation that your current e-commerce is on. You might be moving to Magento. I mean, that's a massive, massive change for Google, because the whole systems are changing. So you've got to work out, first of all, before you go and push a new site live, and this is one of the things most web developers don't do, they don't go and check the index before the new site's live. And if you do that before the new sites go live, you can identify a lot of problems that your existing site already has. You need to get rid of those. You need to get rid of those existing index problems before you push the new site live. The reason for that is that if you push the new site live and you still have all that duplicate content in the index and all those sorts of things, you're not working on a stable foundation. You don't know if the problems that you may have when you push the new site live are part of the problems of the old site. So clean up the index and get the index clean before you push the new site live. Of course, you know, do all your things like your cross-browser checks, all those sorts of things. Your web developers are good at that. The thing that they're not really good at is mirroring the existing ranking elements. And by that, I mean just simple things like page titles. You know, you want to take your existing page titles. The way that I would do it, I would take your existing page titles and put them on the new site on the equivalent pages. And if you're already ranking well, that's a good thing to do. If you've never ranked for anything before, you might want to have a look at SEO on your existing site first before you push the new one live, so you can get some learnings, because it's probably the index that's all messed up, so clean that up. So you're gonna mirror those existing ranking elements, things like page titles, URL structures, search engine friendly URLs, heading tag structures. Navigation structures is one of the ones that people often miss. And that's important because it tells Google a little bit about what you think is important on the site through the navigation structure. So you might have some pages high in the navigation structure which are getting good traffic, and that's because Google sees that they're important to the site. If you change that navigation structure and you take some of that authority away, or that internal linking away from those pages, you will find that they will drop. The actual process that you need to go through before you push that new site live, after you've fixed all those ranking elements, you've brought all those over, now you're ready to go live, then what you have to do is you have to map all the existing URLs of the old site. And to do that, you use a tool like Screaming Frog, Xenu, Integrity, any of those. Map all those URLs, because those URLs on your existing site are going to have to be 301 redirected to the new equivalent URLs. Thankfully, web developers are getting a little bit better than that, but 9 times out of 10, they're still not doing that. And the reason that's important is because if you don't, you're going to be out of the index probably for, depending on the size of the site, 2 weeks to a month. You're not going to be able to be found, because Google will see the new site as broken, because it knows about all these old URLs and you've just gone and blown all those away and you haven't told Google where to redirect them to. So Google thinks, well, the site's broken, until it recrawls gradually. And the bigger the site, the bigger the problem, okay? Because it's going to take longer for Google to recrawl. Once you've done those, what we would call pre-live checks, and you're ready, you've got all your redirects ready, you upload the redirects to the Google, to your server. So, if you're on a Linux server or whatever, you would use a .htaccess file to do that. Ask your web developer, they'll be able to tell you how to do those redirects. And then you've make sure the new site has relative linking, not absolute linking inside the site. And the reason you need to do that is because sometimes on a staging site, the web developer will push it live and it'll have all the links inside. And I've seen this happen several times, will be all the staging site links. So it'll be like stagingmysite.com/, even though it's been pushed to mysite.com is live. So make sure the new site has relative linking, so you're not bringing across sort of staging URLs and all that sort of thing. I've seen it happen a lot. Get a new sitemap, obviously. Upload that to Google Search Console. Make sure you've got Googlebot access to every page on the site, and run something like Screaming Frog over again to ensure that it's error-free and that it's not creating heaps of duplication and all those sorts of things. That's the basis of a good site migration. There's a lot more to it than that. And if you come to the conference, we'll talk about it. Hope to see you there. Thanks very much. Bye from India.